Ever since Apple announced their M1 line of MacBooks, Windows laptops have been struggling to keep up in performance and battery life. So if you are a Windows user who has been looking across the aisle at Apple's laptop offering, I've got some really good news for you guys. Windows laptops are going to get a lot better in the second half of this year. And it's largely because of Intel's new offering. So finally, Intel has decided to wake up from their slumber and deliver some quality silicon. Specifically, I'm talking about Intel's 12th generation Alder Lake CPUs that promise to deliver significant performance and battery life improvements. These mobile CPUs are built on a brand new architecture, making them very competitive against Apple's M1 and possibly their new upcoming M2 chips. So in today's video, I will be talking about two upcoming thin and light Windows laptops powered by the 12th generation Intel Alder Lake CPUs that promise to deliver breakthrough performance and a really long battery life. So specifically, I'm talking about the new version of Acer Swift 5 and Lenovo Flex 5. Now, both these laptops will be powered by the 12th generation Intel Core i7 1260p processor. So this is a 12-core processor. And yes, you guys heard it right. Not quad-core, not hexa-core, but a dodeca-core processor. By the way, dodeca-core is a fancy word for 12 cores, and I had to look it up in the dictionary. So we are talking about a monster 12-core 16-thread laptop processor. It is using a hybrid microarchitecture that is very similar to Apple's M1 chip. It comes with 4 high-performance cores and 8 power-efficient cores. The high-performance cores are capable of reaching up to 4.7 GHz frequency to deliver a kick-ass performance, while the power-efficient cores help deliver a long battery life. So here is a chart showing the Cinebench single-core benchmark of Intel Core i7-1260p compared to Apple's M1 chip and AMD's latest mobile processor, the Ryzen 5700U. As you can see here, Intel comes out ahead of both Apple and AMD in the single-core performance. But thanks to its 12-core hybrid architecture, Intel chip also comes out ahead in the multi-core benchmark. Now in the graphics department, Apple M1 does come out ahead, beating both Intel and AMD in the FP32 benchmark. And this is because right now Apple is way far ahead of Intel and AMD in graphics. But overall, I would say that Intel has made significant gains with Alder Lake CPUs, making it an amazing chip for future thin and light laptops. Now, in order for any Windows laptop to compete with MacBooks, there is one final piece that is still missing, and that's the tight integration between the hardware and the software. So if you look at MacBooks, they deliver great performance and a long battery life, largely because there is an amazing synergy between the macOS and the M1 chip. Thankfully, Windows 11 delivers a similar experience with Intel's 12th generation microprocessors. This is because Intel and Microsoft have jointly developed a new Windows 11 thread scheduler that judiciously allocates appropriate tasks to the high performance core and also the energy efficient cores in Alder Lake CPU. So this ensures that demanding tasks get allocated to the high performance cores, while the more mundane tasks, they run on the power efficient cores. So the end result is that you get superior performance and a long battery life with this processor. Okay, let's start with the first 12th generation Intel Alder Lake laptop that I am really excited about. So it's Lenovo Flex 5, a thin and light 2-in-1 convertible laptop that supports Active Stylus Pen. Now, I have already reviewed this laptop here on this channel, specifically the 11th generation Intel model and also the AMD Ryzen 5000 series model. Those reviews are linked in the video description below, so feel free to check out those videos if you are interested. But I am really looking forward to the 12th generation Intel Alder Lake model of Lenovo Flex 5. This is because the extra CPU and graphics performance coupled with enhanced battery life will make it a very compelling laptop. Now, Flex 5 comes with a great keyboard and also it comes with a great trackpad, and the overall build quality of this laptop is excellent. Its typing experience trumps most other 2-in-1 convertible laptop in the market by delivering adequate key travel distance and a springy tactile feedback. Since this is a 2-in-1 laptop, the quality of the hinge is very important. I have been very pleased with the metallic hinge on Flex 5, which easily transforms this device from a laptop to a tablet. Now, hands down, the best feature of Lenovo Flex 5, in my opinion, is the writing experience with the included Active Pen. So this pen delivers over 4000 levels of pressure sensitivity, and coupled with its low latency, you get an excellent writing experience. Of course, no digital surface will ever feel like real paper, but the included Active Pen has impressed me a lot. I have tried Active Pens on various other Windows laptops, so laptops like Acer Spin 3, Dell Inspiron 2-in-1 and HP NVX360, but Lenovo Flex 5 has always come out on top and has given me the best note-taking experience among all these laptops. But it's not all bed of roses. I would like to see Lenovo improve the display and make this laptop more upgrade friendly. Now, the existing model of Lenovo Flex 5 ships with an LED backlit IPS panel that delivers around 250 nits of peak brightness. While that's okay for daily use, it pales in comparison to something like a MacBook Air or Dell XPS 13, which have much brighter screens. My second gripe with the current generation of Lenovo Flex 5 is the lack of upgrade options. So the RAM is soldered to the motherboard and cannot be upgraded, and that kind of sucks. Honestly, I don't know if Lenovo is going to fix these features, but I can hope that, you know, in the newer model, they improve the screen and they also give us a user upgradable RAM option. Now let's talk about the other 12th generation Intel Alder Lake laptop that I am eagerly awaiting. It's Acer Swift 5, an extremely thin and light laptop. It is priced right under $1,500, and at the time of making this video, Acer Swift 5 was not yet available for purchase here in the United States. Unlike Lenovo Flex 5, Acer Swift 5 is not a 2-in-1 convertible laptop, but what you do get is an exceptional build quality and extremely thin and light design. I have already reviewed Acer Swift 5 with the 11th generation Intel Core i7 processor here on this channel. That video is linked below, so if you guys are interested, please check it out. What I love about Acer Swift 5 is its premium build quality. Acer has used an aerospace grade aluminum chassis, which gives this laptop solid structural rigidity while keeping the weight down to only 2.65 pounds or 1.2 kilograms. Its screen quality is also superior to Lenovo Flex 5. You get a higher 2560x1600 resolution screen with a peak brightness of 340 nits. Now that is roughly comparable to what you get with MacBook Air. This screen delivers 100% sRGB color gamut, making it a great laptop choice for creators who edit videos and photos on their laptop. I also love its narrow bezels, which deliver an impressive 90% screen to body ratio. Now when you open Acer Swift 5, the copper bronze metallic color scheme immediately jumps out. Its keyboard uses bronze lettering, which is truly unique color combo, giving this laptop a very premium flair in my opinion. I think Acer Swift 5 will surely turn heads when used in a public place. But if you believe in right to repair, you will be severely disappointed with Acer Swift 5. Nothing is user upgradable or accessible in this laptop. But at least Acer is giving you plenty of ports. So you are getting two USB Type-C Thunderbolt 4 ports that supports 10 gigabits per second data transfer speed, ability to drive a 4K monitor at 60Hz refresh rate, and 65 watt power delivery support for rapid battery charging. In addition, you are also getting an HDMI port. You're getting two USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A port along with support for the latest Wi-Fi 6 and the Bluetooth standard. Now regarding the battery life, Acer Swift 5 comes with a large 56 watt hour battery that can run this laptop for 12 hours at least. So that's pretty impressive. Now the included battery charger supports fast charging, so you can easily add an extra 4 hours of battery life with just 30 minutes of charging. So overall, I think Acer Swift 5 is a perfect Windows laptop for someone looking for a thin and light MacBook Air alternative. Like I mentioned before, both these laptops with the Intel Alder Lake chips have not yet been released here in the United States. But as soon as they do become available, I will review both these laptops here on this channel. So please subscribe to this channel if you are not already subscribed to. In the meantime, if you are looking for a thin and light 2-in-1 touchscreen laptop that supports Active Stylus Pen, check out this video over here. In this video, I list my top 5 favorite 2-in-1 laptops. So you guys are going to find this video very useful. So go ahead and watch this video, and I will see you guys over there. Bye.